For more on the latest developments surrounding the upcoming presidential poll, now here, of course, I'm joined by my colleague Idrissa Fall from Voice of America's French to Africa service, who is also, by the way, a native of Senegal. Good afternoon, Idrissa.
Good afternoon, Shaka.
How are you? It's a long time since I last saw you on Straight Talk Africa,
my
man.
Thank you for having me, and good afternoon to your listeners and viewers.
Yeah, I know that you obviously have been monitoring the situation back home on a daily basis. And of course, you do have people say that the incumbent president should stay out of this. Why do they want the president to stay out of it when the Constitutional Commission itself has endorsed that he is eligible to run for office?
Well, the argument of the opposition is Mr. Wade wrote a constitution which does not allow him to run for free mandates. Mr. Wade said that constitution does not apply to him. And besides that, the opposition also is telling that he's too old. That is not the argument, but that is the position of the opposition. And now, after the Constitutional Council allow Mr. Wade to participate, they are organizing a rally in the country to have him withdraw his candidacy. So it's where we are right now.
Talking about Mr. Wade's age, we're talking about 85 years young here. Is that correct?
Yes, approximately.
But we do know, for example, that your constitution of the Republic of Senegal does not really have a limit as to how old you have to be in order not to be eligible to run for office.
To be honest, legally, no. There is no binding about age in the constitution saying that Mr. Wade is not allowed to run. And Mr. Wade, his argument is the constitution on which I was elected when I arrived in power in 2000 did not have that new procurement telling that the limitation of two mandates. That is the whole debate right now. And I think legally, it's very, very tricky to get into that. And the European and the US, I think, are very cautious because they are not telling Mr. Wade you don't have the right to run. They say we would wish to have a change of generation, things like that, and which does not mean a lot.
They want a younger person to be running for office, is that correct?
Well, when you say a change of generation, I think Mr. Moustapha Niass is not a young guy. And what does it mean, a young generation?
Who are you talking about?
Moustapha Niass is a novel candidate who is over 70s, and he's not that young. So,
what about the average or ordinary Senegalese? What are his views? What are the views of the ordinary Senegalese so far from what you have been able to gather?
Well, it's a county divided, but because when you see when Mr. Wade is organizing rallies inside Senegal, you will see thousands and thousands of people running after him. When the opposition organize rallies, you see in Dakar, you'll have thousands of people. And right now, a lot of people are scared of the violence these past days. And so I think even when I called this morning, some people are beginning buying some supplies and keep them in their houses because people think it may get worse. I think Mr. Wade and some candidate want the election to be held. Others are calling now to have it postponed. And Mr. Obasanjo is there. Today he met several leaders of the opposition. He met with members of the Electoral Commission. And I think maybe tonight or tomorrow he's going to meet with President Wade.
Now, Idrissa, a lot of people and indeed Western reporters have been looking at the situation in Senegal as perhaps Africa's oldest democracy. But what about the appearances that would suggest that perhaps even in Senegal, actually, there is no difference really between the ruling party and the state?
Well, I think it's a little bit different because the ruling party actually in Senegal arrived in power in 2000. Some people are accusing them like corruption, and I think that the representative of Mr. Wade, who is here, may not agree. But the state, the core of the state of Senegal, had been working beside the political parties. So I think we have a government which can work And even when the change came in 2000, the government is there. We have a lot of competent people who continue working for the country, I think.
How do you explain to someone who will say, wait a minute, Idriss, because when, for example, President Wade and his supporters are having, for example, a political rally downtown Dakar, you do not see the police coming with tear gas and what have you, but that when the opposition have rallies or demonstrations downtown Dakar, you see the police very busy, you know, with their tear gas?
Well, that is a question because Serigne Bakenjai, who's spokesman for Mr. Wade, said, I think 2 days ago, that they can rally everywhere. And the interior minister is saying if they want a rally at the independent place, that may present a risk. It's so that they are forbidding them, and some opponents want to be there at the independent place. Even today, I heard Idrissa Fall telling that they are going to return to the independent place. So, and be it. I know that they're having accusation from side to side. The government saying that the opposition is trying to provoke the police, and the police saying that some members of the opposition threw some stones on them. But if you are not on the ground, we cannot know, really. I know that so far at least 6 people were killed. Yeah.
Idriss, if you were to talk to me from the deepest bitter part of your Senegalese heart and soul, why do you sincerely think that President Wade wants to stay in State House despite what the opposition and every other people are saying? This is a man who obviously has incredible democratic credentials, at least in the past. This is a man who stayed in the opposition for 25 years. This is a man, frankly, who has made a difference, at least to the development of his country. Why does he want to hang on to power? Is it because he sees a lot of his colleagues on the continent doing the same, or what?
Well, to be honest, I can repeat what some Senegalese are saying. They say the president, since he came, he's tried to put his son to power. But that thing, myself, I interviewed Mr. Wade several times, he said it's not true. And everybody remember back in June 2010, when he was trying to have a ticket of vice president and being able to be elected with 25% of the vote, people went out and he withdrew that project. And now some people are saying he want to run again, stay there for a while, and then find a way to give the power to his son, who has a super ministry. But that thing is what some Senegalese and some opponents are saying. But Mr. Wade himself, what he say, he want to finish some project he began, like building an airport outside Dakar, building some road, is what he himself is saying. But myself, I cannot judge him.
What about people who say that he's basically, just like some of his colleagues, really, simply power hungry?
Well, I don't know.
That part you don't know?
I don't know, really. Power hungry, I don't know. I will give my own judgment, and I cannot allow myself to do so.
What about his accomplishments? What would you say are some of his most important accomplishments during the last 12 years?
Wade is the one, he arrived in power democratically, beating Abdou Diouf in 2000. He changed the constitution in 2001 and brought that limitation of mandate. He changed again that constitution because the first constitution of 2001, the mandate had to be at for 5 years, and then he changed it again, put it to 7 years. It means that he, if he's reelected, he'll be there for maybe 19 years or maybe more. He built roads. Everybody who arrived in Senegal know that under Wade, he changed a lot of things in the country. Mm-hmm. When you leave the airport of Dakar and going inside Dakar and inside the country, everybody may agree that Mr. Wade built several roads, changed the face of Dakar. But what he began, maybe somebody else could finish it. And it's what people don't understand. When you begin a good job, you can let somebody else finish it. So, but he did something for the country. But right now, having people being killed because he want to run again, he could have a leaving the power nicely, like former President Senghor did in 1980. He could leave the power like elegantly former President Abdoulaye Wade did in 2000, accepting he was beaten at the election. What would he lose? Nobody knows.
Well, Idriss, thank you so much for your insight.